Welcome to another episode of Dala's Kitchen. This is Chef Abdallah, your host, kama kawaida. You know what? What are we going to do today with all these ingredients that this guy is showing? Mbona hakuna nyama hapa? There's no meat today. There's something wrong. No, but anyway, there's nothing wrong with vegetables. One, we have to support our farmers. We have to eat healthy. Vegetables are good, especially when you have kids. It's good to start introducing them to eating vegetables when they're still young. Vegetables are not yucky, as most people say. Vegetables are healthy. Mimi nakula vegetables 5 times a week. 2 days nakula meat. It's not because I don't like meat, but vegetables are healthy. Anyway, today I've got this opportunity to bring in another professional chef. But this is not just your ordinary professional chef. It's a female chef. You know how difficult it is to get a female chef then at the top. Like most of the chefs who come into my show, they are wajuu kabisa. Eh? It's so difficult to get one, but this chef has really proved herself. She's moved everywhere, and she's leading a hotel kitchen right now full of men. Wamejaa wanaume, anawapeleka mbio, ninasikia huyu chef kama ni Chef Robai is my guest today. And Chef Robai used to be at Sarova. Huko, hebu sema kwa nguvu, acha kuogopa. Just sema kama ewe. Kule beach.
Yeah,
ulikuwa na suntan. Kwa hiyo kitanda unalala huko na wacha kwani there was no season. You think we don't know about you chefs? Wanaamka asubuhi anaenda kwa kitanda analala hapo alafu anajifanya yuko busy. So you were at Sarova White Sands before?
Yes.
Mombasa?
Yes.
And then now ukaja ulipoacha Sarova ndio ukakuja?
Nikakuja niko Tamarind Tree.
Uko Tamarind Tree.
Tamarind Tree Hotel.
For those people who don't know where Tamarind Tree, it's one of the new hotels. It was opened about 2 years ago, I think, something like that.
2016.
Wow, time flies. It seems just like the other day.
We opened the door in 2017.
2017 you opened the door, yeah.
Yes.
It's just next to Carnival, next to the National Park. Apo Langata Road, ukiingia kwa hivi kidogo. Asa mimi nimepiga roundabout, ukiingia tu kidogo kwa hivi. How challenging is it to manage men? How many females do you have? Let's start with how many females do you have in your kitchen?
I have 4 females in my kitchen.
Okay.
And about 30 men.
Holy smokes, yes. Unaona. There is no gender balance in this hotel. No, the thing is that's how the industry is. While most of the females are the ones who cook at home, when it comes to professional life, I don't know where our sisters end up. There's something wrong. We need to change this balance. Eh?
Today's menu, vegetable Swahili.
So, what are you making? You told me you wanted to make something vegetarian.
Today we are making vegetarian.
Yeah.
I'll call it vegetable Swahili.
Okay.
Because I'll use most of the coast spices.
Flavors, I can see.
Yes.
Naona niko na kajinja.
Kuna kajinja hapa, tangawizi.
Oh, niko na cardamom. Cardamom inaitwaje?
Iliki.
Iliki.
Yeah.
Mimi ni mtu wa majuu. Do I know what cardamom is? Tena these are fresh.
Yeah,
it's
fresh.
Not the,
yes.
It's not the
we use
powder.
The whole one, not the powder.
Okay.
We have cumin seeds.
Cumin seed.
And we have garlic,
okay.
We call it kitungu
saumu.
And we have turmeric.
Okay, to give it that color?
Yes.
Okay. Turmeric Kiswahili naitwa manjano. Okay, Kiswahili, turmeric manjano. Okay, na Mombasa, huku kwetu kwa wazungu, huku Nairobi, unasema turmeric.
Turmeric,
na Mombasa, sema,
kwanza unaongeza kale ka
turmeric. Unasema nataka mandano, sio manjano, mandano.
We have tamarind.
Ukwaju.
This is tamarind juice, ukwaju.
Yeah, if you're coming from overseas, you call it ukwaju. Can I have some ukwaju? Yeah, but hapa ni ukwaju.
Ni ukwaju.
Tamarind.
Yes, and we have coconut milk.
You know what? Iyo ni yako. Sasa, go ahead, show this show. I'll come and join you later on. Just do your work. Hebu wow them. You know what? Mi hata ninaogopa.
So, we need to wash our hands first. So we'll put some vegetable oil, and then we onions. So you have to cook the onions. Make sure the onions cook well. But I'll not brown my onions. And together with the onions, you can also put your spices. I'll put my cumin and cardamom. You don't need to add the garlic and ginger because the onion will burn out. So we'll just cook the onion, cardamom, and cumin seeds together. And also again, by doing this, you are able to get all the flavors from the cardamom and the cumin. Then after that is when now you can add your garlic. And ginger. You have to be very careful with ginger because when you put a lot of ginger, your food is going to have a very bad taste. So you just have to do little ginger to get the flavor. You have to cook it, and you can also smell the spices from the garlic, ginger, cumin, and cardamom. Then now this is where you can add your turmeric. And your tomato paste. You just put a little tomato paste. You see, the reason why we put tomato paste before tomatoes is to cook out the tomato. The tomato paste. And after everything is cooked, you can see everything is cooked well here. Very nice color. Even the aroma, you can smell it out. And then this is where you can add your tomatoes. In the kitchen, you have to practice clean as you go. So I'm trying to clear out the empty containers. Then here you mix very well. You have to make sure you mix everything. And you let it cook out. You have to make sure you've cooked all the water from the tomatoes. As you can see here, it has to boil fast. Boil nicely, you keep on stirring so that it doesn't stick. And you let it cook slowly. You don't need to rush it because you need to cook the tomatoes well. Now you can add your salt. You have to be very careful. Just do little, then you'll taste it. So I have to make sure all the water is cooked out. So you just let it simmer slowly. We call it simmer, kupika pole pole. Unaipika pole pole mpaka maji ishe. As you can see, it's almost drying up. Now we can add our coconut milk. Before you add our coconut milk, we add tamarind juice. Tamarind juice is a bit tangy, so I'll add some little sugar. Yeah, and it's also a binder. You can see it's thick, nicely thick. And tamarind is also good for your liver. It's good for pressure. You can take it as a juice, not only for cooking. You can make desserts with tamarind, juice, some desserts. Then I can add now my coconut. Coconut, waswahili wanaita tui. uko kwa kina Abdalla uko. Wanaita tui. This sauce is good because you can not only use it with vegetables, but you can cook it with chicken, fish. Fish is also good. You can call it Swahili fish or coconut and tomato fish or chicken. So you don't need to put all of it. You can also cook your sauce and keep it. It can stay in the fridge for 2 to 3 days. So you can use it for cooking other things. So you see, you can see nice color with our sauce. So we also let the coconut cook well. And now that our sauce is simmering, kupika pole pole, we'll take a short break, and when we come back, we'll make now our vegetable. Our sauce will be ready.